this video will be how to ask a girl out, because she has had shit experience with this in the past and it ethically failed, so we thought we should make a video to clear it up for boys who just are useless.
Yeah. Do not ask a girl on a social networking site, "Oh, I like someone."
Who?
You know them.
You know, yes, it may be obvious to you who you like, but it's not obvious to us.
Do not play the riddle game.
Yes, do not play the riddle game, because it gets very old very quickly and very annoying.
Number two.
Do not ask a girl to marry you before you ask them out. My ex-partner, recently, a couple of days ago, instead of asking me out, was, "Will you marry me?"
Why?
Just, "Will you marry me?" And I'm trying to give reasons why you should ask someone out first, and it's like, "No, just marry me."
Just wrong. No. Never do that.
Never ask a girl out within a couple of weeks, because you don't know if the relationship's going to last. At least wait a year. A year to ask someone to marry you. And then 2 or 3 more years after that before you actually get married.
Actually make sure they're the right person before. "Hey, do you want to marry me?"
Yeah, make sure the other person feels that way about you as well. And this goes for girls as well. Don't just feel you have to say yes because they've asked you. Don't settle. It's not a good thing to do, is to settle, is it?
No. I never have high expectations, because that just leads to disappointment.
Yeah. And before ask someone to marry you, let them spend like a couple of days at your place. No, it is.
Just a couple of days.
But a couple of days, like a couple of weeks or something.
I'd at least stay with them, be with them for about a year before you literally turn.
Yeah, but I mean like, to see if they'd be good living with you. That's what I mean, live with them for like a couple of weeks or a couple of days at first, then slowly and gradually increase the time. So then, you don't want to marry someone who you think's the love of your life.
And it turns out to be a fucking pig and doesn't clean up shit.
Yeah. Every girl knows that a lad will leave the toilet seat up. It's the most disgusting thing. Because if you want to go for a pee, first thing in the morning, the last thing you want to do is fall through the fucking toilet.
I've used that a few times before, haven't you?
I've even done it when my fucking dad's been here. You just, you know, sometimes lads just forget. You know, and you should be honest if you're in a relationship and not bottle things up. Because if you bottle things up, they don't know that they're in the wrong. So if you start being funny with them, they don't know why.
And if you're going out with someone and they do something you really hate, or you don't feel it's the right person, at least complain. Otherwise, it's just pointless.
Yeah, and don't, like, never be afraid that you're never going to find someone better. If you truly love someone, and you feel like they're the right person for you, awesome! And there's a hell of a lot of smoke going in front of the camera. Sorry about that.
Sponsored by cigarettes.
Yeah. Sponsored by Swan. Extra slim filters. We're not, by the way, before anyone complains, especially Swan.
You know, they complain to Swan. Why the fuck are you sponsoring kids that obviously look underage to smoke to do this?
Technically, the law is, in the UK, 16 to smoke.
16 to get married without permission.
Yeah.
Considering it's a day not subject here.
But 16 to smoke and 18 to buy.
Oh, we have a friend's request on BBM.
But getting back on subject,
what's another rule, number 3? We should at least have 10.
Yeah.
Rule
number 3. If you're with someone, and, like, say for instance, like, I'm bi, so is my friend Hannah here.
I'm a bisexual.
We are both bisexuals, and we've both gone out with straight men.
And girls.
And straight girls, but by all lesbian girls and straight lads. Lads, most of the time, as you say, you're a bi girl,
threesome!
And it's no.
Unless she's very willing, do not bring that up in conversation straight away.
Yes, at least you're going out for a while before you even attempt to bring it up.
That's kind of like the last option when you're done with all the experimental shit. Actually ask that question before, and make sure the girl that you actually want to sleep with, she fancies as well, otherwise it's just no.
Yeah, a that's what I was saying. Oh, I fancied this girl for a while. Then why the fuck are you going out with me, bitch?
Yeah? Rule number four would be never play friends off against each other, because we've had that happen as well, and that's just the worst, really, because it puts a brig on.
Oh, Hannah, you're so fit. Ceris, I'm going to snog you.
What? Yeah, we have this friend, well, so
one of my friends from high school. I went out with, he's an ex of mine. Played us two off against each other, telling me that you liked me and telling her that you liked her, but not telling each other that you both liked each other, which is wrong. You should never do that with friends, because as they say, dick may come and go, but true friends will stay forever.
Exactly. And then if you've gone out with someone and it's your first relationship, if you're going out with a girl and it's your first female-female relationship, if you feel uncomfortable, tell them.
Yeah, be very honest, especially if it's your first either gay or lesbian experience. Be very honest, because most of the time your partner will understand, especially if it's someone that's had a couple of lesbian relationships. Everyone finds it strange at first, even if you know you're a lesbian or a bi girl inside. It's still going to be a bit strange, because not everyone is as open with...
Yeah, most people.
Yeah, not everyone's open with bis and lesbians and gays. But which is really, really stupid. And if you're homophobic, fuck off. Do not be watching my video. Do not be watching our videos.
Well, number five would definitely be, if you actually fancy someone, tell them instead of leading them astray, like someone we've known as well.
If you like someone, do not be like, oh, I like you, and then fuck off and go out with someone else.
Which has happened to me in the past. Which
has happened to me in the past.
The best experience in the world.
Because it gives you a so low expectation. You know, it makes you feel like, oh, what the fuck did I do wrong? Why don't they like me?
Never tell someone you like them or love them, and then if they ask their friends, ask you, would you ever go out with them, and then say no, because it's just wrong.
Yeah, and never, ever get your friends to ask someone you like, do they like you? If you like someone, grow a pair and ask them yourself. Yeah.
But you showed it at me.
I know, yeah. If you if I like someone, I will fucking go up and say to him, look, I like you, do you want to go out with me? Yeah, it may not be the best way of doing it.
I did tell her in the end, but then she was just like being funny.
Yeah.
And the other person involved in this conversation, even though I don't know if he would ever watch this, decided that he would try to go out with her as well. And then she come running back to me saying, oh, I'll never go out with him because I like you. And then suddenly blanked for the rest of the day.
Yeah, which is really weird, because the girl that she likes, my ex-partner wanted to get with, the one that asked me to marry him.
We have a window. People have been spying on us and telling us secrets.
Yes.
And if you actually want to meet someone off the internet, meet them, but
take a friend.
Or somewhere safe.
Yeah, never, meet them in public somewhere. Like, say, I'll meet you, but I'll meet you in the centre of town. Somewhere that's open, somewhere there's cameras, somewhere there's a lot of people. Never meet someone late at night if you don't know them.
I never agree to meet someone and then blow them off, because I've done that in the past. It really pisses people off.
Yes, especially if they know in the area that you live. Look, when I've done that, and then I've seen them a couple of weeks in town going, I've been looking for you, oh shit. I did nothing. I said nothing.
And if it's someone you know, like a friend of a friend, take that friend that you've been friends with them, so then the conversation doesn't get awkward in the middle of something like, hi, what do I say now? Shit.
Yeah. And don't be like really, really, really too open. Because
you've done that shit loads of times.
But with me, I don't care if people know I'm bi. It's like, they first meet me, hi, I'm Ceris, I'm bi. But don't be telling people your darkest secrets. And if it's someone you're meeting for the first time, keep the conversation light. Don't be like, what's your politics views and how many kids do you want to have?
What you want on your gravestone?
Yeah, what you want on your gravestone, when are you going to get married?
I curse the man that moves my bones.
Yes.
Sorry, Dabby, I admit that. It was just pure amazement that I just wanted that. Oh, come dig me up, there's buried treasure.
Be on a grave somewhere, come pick me up, there's buried treasure.
Come dig me up, it'll be the best fright of your life.
Well, there you go, it's like, but when you meet someone, keep it light. And always take a friend with you, because,
Like, if it's someone's ex, ask your friend first. Like, if you ever want to watch one of my exes.
Which I did, and then I told you about it, and then you fucked us both over, which was not the best conversation in the world, but...
Ask your friend first, because the one thing you do not want to do is lose a friend over someone that's not going to last.
Or lose a friend over something that you don't think is going to last yourself.
Yeah. And never be in a relationship just purely because you want to be in a relationship. But don't do it because you don't feel like you've got nothing else to do.
Well, number six. Don't frog hop relationships.
Yes. At least have a couple of days at least in between relationships. Rebounds do not work.
Because then you just harbour the feelings for your ex, and if it gets too serious and you see your ex again, it just goes...
Plus, you're also hurting yourself and the person that you're with, which is not fair on either of you.
Seven!
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 Sorry, we're getting used to the camera.
Yeah, this is my first vlog and I'm shit.
Never,
I keep forgetting it's backwards.
Never sleep with someone within a week of going out with them.
Good rule, good rule.
Yeah, because you don't want to be like the slag. Sorry for girls that have watched this that have done that, but it is a bit slaggish. You know, it's like, I'm not sure if it's going to work, but I'll sleep with you anyway.
Eight, do not be fuck buddies with someone you consider a best friend.
Yes, that can ruin friendships.
If you can't be fuck buddies, which I have nothing about against or anything, don't pick someone you know completely and truly through and through.
Yes. Do not pick someone that you could fancy.
Or someone that you already have feelings for.
Because that'll just fuck you over, especially if that person does not like you in the same way. Fuck buddies can be a great thing for people that cannot physically do relationships. Fuck buddies can be a hell of a lot better than actual relationships for some people. Some people only work in fuck buddies than in a relationship itself.
Number eight, do not fall for a playboy. Most definitely do
not
do
fall
that.
For a playboy.
Do you wanna
hands
go?
Up if you've done this!
Do you want to tell the story first or shall I? Which one should we tell first? Should we tell the one that fucked us both over, who was a registered playboy around the area that most people in our rock community actually know about? Or the one that you know about personally?
Well, the one that I know about personally, he's an ex of mine. Went out, broke up. He never seems for more than 2 days to be without in a relationship. And he actually is addicted to sex.
You cannot go physically a day without it.
He went out with me and I think I made him wait 2 weeks, didn't I?
Yeah, I think it was about that, yeah.
Yeah, and he looked like he was in actual agony because he had not had it.
See, I've heard about doing it so long, but you know.
Well, if you'd wanted to feel like someone else, just lie on your arm for a couple of minutes. Composure.
This is meant to be serious. We're trying to help these young, misguided people that probably look a lot like us.
No, probably.
Probably as rock-based orientated as us.
If you are rock or an emo, do not go out with a chav.
Definitely
go out with someone that have the same kind of interests as you.
Well, that's basically number nine. Always go out with people that you could be friends with afterwards.
Yes.
Or someone that you actually have an attraction with, that you look, that has the same sort of taste as you.
Like my mum and dad, they both have the same kind of music interests, they both have the same kind of film interests, which they have something to talk about. Like, if I ever went out, well, I actually have gone out with a chav. All my music is rock based or classical. I don't really do pop, and all he wants to listen to is pop, and I felt like my ears were bleeding. And if I ever listened to rock music, he felt like his ears were bleeding.
No offense to any child out there, but
no, it's
not basically stating that if you want to go out with someone, at least have a few things in common, like music,
films,
clothes. Things you do in your spare time, like reading or skateboarding or whatever.
Yeah, your hobbies. I am a confessed bookworm.
Me too.
We will read anything.
Yeah, so I've just got vampires in it for me, you know.
I have read a dictionary. I was bored once. I read a dictionary.
I did that in school. It was either doing much homework or read dictionary.
Read the dictionary. No one wants to do homework.
And don't push someone into sex they feel uncomfortable with. Like, if you're into bondage or whatever, say a masochism, threesomes, don't push someone into that if they don't want to do it, because it'll just make them feel uncomfortable.
Yeah, if you are into the kinkier sides of sex, have a sit down and have a conversation about it after you've been going out for a while.
You're right, Miss Grey.
I'm okay, thank you very much. Yes, I've been nicknamed Miss Grey because I have this side of me. But never just, if it's your first time having sex with someone, do not bring that side of you out. You know, if you are just fully, just want a sex life, do not go out with someone if they do not know that's all you are looking for. Be completely honest.
That sounds familiar already.
What, Ben?
Hey,
I don't give a shit. You're Ben, you had Liam, who's my ex, you asked me to marry him, you have Seb, that fucked us both over.
What are we going to do if they actually watch this? Our lives are good. They're just going to come and rape our houses or something.
No, Liam I think would be alright, plus he doesn't have a computer.
You're going to wake up with tissue paper covering the house. Seb would probably be pissed off.
Seb would kill my rats.
Probably. Ben, he doesn't really know where I live, so
Ben,
I'm fine.
Ben doesn't know where I live.
We're both, well, I'm safe, you're just fucked. Bye bye.
No, I'm safe as well, because he knows that if he ever tried anything, I could punch his lights out.
Just don't do that, you know. When I find him, I'll punch him.
I never, ever go out with someone that does not know how to communicate.
At all.
I confess I bottle my emotions.
Well, look, mine was like, you know, we've been texting for like about 2 years now,
yeah.
And all you ever get is, hey, you okay? Yeah, you okay? Bye. I don't know what the fuck he's thinking.
Yeah, you don't know what they're thinking or if they actually like you back.
Oh, I'm on my Xbox. I'll talk later.
Yeah, what you have to? I'm on my Xbox. Is that all you do? Do not go out with someone who just lives inside.
Gaming nerds are fit, yes, and sexy sometimes, but if you're actually going to go out with a gaming nerd, actually pick someone that you play the same games. So you can actually interact via game.
Pick someone that can share a game.
Exactly.
That's not like, I cannot be two-player, it's just me. That is not a good thing to do, and I think we've gone over the 10 books back.
Yes, we will carry on with this till we finish ranting our shit.
Yes.
What one is it?
Never go out with someone who buys more than one or two phones a year. Because if they can't commit to a phone, how are they going to commit to a human being?
Oh, that's the other one, ain't it? Because
that's Liam. If you ever watch this.
Liam. Hello.
Hello. He's actually looking for a new phone. He's asked me to look for him.
Oh, dear God. What do you do with this one?
This one, if you ever find someone that you like, but they cannot commit to anything, a phone,
a dog,
a contract, a dog,
a house, keeping money.
Yeah, how are you ever gonna, you know, have a life with them? If they cannot commit to having the same fucking phone for more than a couple of months, how are they gonna commit to you?
And don't go out with someone that's just using you for your money.
Or
I've seen
sex.
This done so many times, and it is so annoying. Yeah, it's alright to ask a mate, can I have a fag, or can I borrow this every now and again? But if all they constantly do is, can I have this? Can I have that? Why are they even going out with you if that's all they ever ask? Just no.
That is a very good point.
Exactly. Thank you.
Does it, that even goes for friendships. Because with us two, we'll borrow each other's stuff, but we always give it back and we always pay each other back.
True.
It's like, we go into the town, you buy a drink one day, the next day I buy like four and give you two.
Quid's worth, it's good.
I'm addicted to energy drinks, so it's all good.
Never, if you're committed to someone, age is seriously just a number. Unless they're like really mature and you're just completely childish. Because otherwise it's going to end up being like child and dad thing. Don't do this. Don't run there. Don't do this.
Because with me, I always say age is but a number. Except if you're under the age of 17. If you're under the age of 17, you should not be going out with anyone older than 18.
Unless your parents agree to it.
Unless your parents agree to it. Because it is against the law.
True.
If it's legal and you're both committed to it, then yeah, you know, it's fine. It doesn't, you don't have, don't listen to what anyone else says. If you both are happy, fine. If other people don't like it, then they're not part of the relationship. Don't let other people split you up.
It's like, people can judge people in so many ways. Labels, age. It's just not worth it. At the end of the day, we're all human beings, and we all tick by the same clock. So, what's the point?
We all live, we all breathe.
We all die.
We all die, we all fucking bleed.
Exactly. And if you're going out with someone, just make sure that your interests are at heart, first of all. Never put someone in front of your happiness, because at the end of the day, happiness is what you need in a relationship more than anything. And trust, of course.
Yeah, if you don't feel happy, but you don't trust someone, they are not the right person for you. It may be difficult to hear, but they are not the right person for you. You cannot have love without trust.
And don't just go spying on people and raiding their phones as well, because I've seen that done as well. There's no point, if you don't trust someone, just going through their phone, because it'll just hurt you more if you find the evidence that you're looking for, or the fact that they were telling the truth all along, and then you feel guilty for actually doing it in the first place.
And if they catch you doing it, how can they trust you again?
Exactly. It's like, we talked about a lot of shit. We need more to talk about.
Well, I think we're going to end the video there.
No, we need more.
Well, we may do another video in like a couple of seconds.
Oh,
we'll talk about something else.
Oh, we still got to talk about the lesbian and gay side of relationships on this thing. So,
even though we've been going for like 22 minutes.
People do watch them that long, you know, so.
True.
What would you say the most important thing to learn from going out with a girl is?
The most important thing about going out with a girl is, to be completely honest, that you have many different types of lesbians. You have many different types of bi girls.
Butch, feminine.
You have the chapstick lesbians, the lipstick lesbians.
Chapstick lesbians.
Chapstick lesbians are like a cross between girly girl and butch. So you can have the long hair, but they can still punch you out.
Oh, kind of like me if I kind of turned a full-blown lesbian.
Yes.
In the future. Maybe.
I'd most probably be a butch lesbian. I don't think I could be girly if I tried, except for this.
Mostly. Well, basically, so the lipstick lesbians are like the proper girly girl
yes.
type, which most people get configuratedly screwed with from fictional lesbians. No, lesbians do not just dress girly and act
not all lesbians.
Well, not normal, but they don't act
weird.
Completely different from everyone else.
Not all lesbians have really short hair, boy features, like no boobs, built like a brick shit house. No, yeah, like we said, you have the chapstick lesbians and the lipstick lesbians who, you know, have the long hair. You can have lesbians with short hair that wear lots of makeup and revealing clothing. You can never know someone's sexuality unless you ask. And if you feel shy about asking, grow a pair.
Watch. That's what I do. I just keep watching them and seeing the traits all the way. Oh, we have a phone call. Shall we
have a phone call?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, you?
Oh, crap, yes, meeting you, aren't I?
Well, bye, YouTube.
Sorry, me and Hannah.